Bethel African Methodist Episcopal Church in Evanston, Illinois. We greet you in Jesus' name. Today we are excited about Resurrection Sunday. We know that over 2,000 years ago, that first Easter was very similar to what we're going through now. That first Easter, the disciples were in their homes, hiding, afraid to come out because of the fear of their life. This Easter is one we'll never forget because we too are sheltered in place, concerned about coming out because of COVID-19. But we thank God because of virtual connection, we're still connecting and having a happy Easter. We celebrate Jesus' resurrection, not just this Sunday, but every Sunday. God bless you and God keep you as you partake in the service this morning.
Come now, my King. Help us.
On the throne, who is the Lamb. To him be all blessings. and honor and glory and might.
He is worthy, the risen Christ, the resurrection one. Praise him. Praise his holy name.
Truly, you are worthy of all praise, Lord God. We thank you, O Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, that despite the times, oh Heavenly Father, you are with us, oh Lord God. So we thank you, oh Heavenly Father. So Lord God, we just ask that you come in, oh Lord God. Come in and be with us, oh Heavenly Father. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God. Now, Lord, we ask that as we gather together, Lord God, that you, oh Heavenly Father, knowing that we are in agreement, Lord God, then we know that you are in the place. So Father God, we just ask that you would touch, Lord God. Touch, Lord God, the singing, oh Heavenly Father. Touch, Lord God, the praise. And Father God, we ask that you would touch, Lord God, the one who will break the bread of life this day, Lord God. Touch, Lord God. Place your anointing upon her, O Heavenly Father. Lord God, let your word go forth, O Heavenly Father, for we know it is true and everlasting. So, Father, we just give you the praise. We give you the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
I will be reading Mark chapter 16, verses 1 through 8. Saturday evening, when the Sabbath ended, Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of James, and Salome went out and purchased burial spices so that they could anoint Jesus' body. Very early on Sunday morning, just at sunrise, they went to the tomb. On the way, they were asking each other, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" But as they arrived, they looked up and saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled aside. When they entered the tomb, they saw a young man clothed in white robes sitting on the right side. The women were shocked. But the angel said, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He isn't here. He is risen from the dead. Look, this is where they laid his body. Now go and tell the disciples, including Peter, that Jesus is going ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there, just as he told you before he died." The women fled from the tomb, trembling and bewildered, and they said nothing to anyone because they were too frightened. The word of God for the people of God.
When Jesus, he come down.
heart, God. We thank you for those that prayed and scriptures that were read, Father. We thank you for those that are in virtual land are being blessed by what has already transpired. Lord God, take this servant, God, and wrap me in your loving arms, God. Lord, anoint me for this season of preaching right now in the name of Jesus. And then, oh God, we pray that somebody will hear the word and be blessed by it. Somebody will hear the word and decide that I want to say, what must I do to be saved? Hallelujah. Somebody will hear the word today, God, and want to rededicate their life back unto you. So we thank you. Have you got my way. And I give you praise in advance for it. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Our theme today is Life Beyond the Stone. Mark 16, 1 through 8. And I'm just going to read just a little bit of it. This has already been read for you. I'm going to read here, starting verse 4. Then they looked up and saw that he had rolled back, and it was a huge stone, and walked right in. They saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed all in white. They were completely taken aback and astonished. He said, "Don't be afraid, for I know you're looking for Jesus, the Nazarene, the one that they nailed on the cross. He's been raised up. He is no longer here. You can see for yourselves that the place is empty. Now on your way, go tell his disciples and Peter that he's going ahead of you to Galilee. You'll see him there exactly as he said." The word of God for the people of God, verses 4 through 7. This first Easter morning, early in the morning, the sun is not quite risen, and we see Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome on their way to the tomb. They were going to the tomb where Jesus was just buried in a borrowed tomb. On their way, they began to conversate as they walked past the stained crosses where the three bodies had hung. As they walked in the sun is just setting, they began to discuss who will move the stone. See, when you see that when Jesus was laid in the borrowed tomb, that the stone was put in front of the opening of the tomb to seal it. And the Roman soldiers were placed there in front to guard it so the disciples would not come and steal the body, which the pilot, the chief priest, thought that they would do. As these women were walking, they were looking for not a living Lord, but looking for a corpse. They did not know that he was now living in Sunday, not on Saturday. For Saturday, they had shattered dreams and in hopes. Saturday, they found that this Christ that they believed, the Messiah that they believed would be their earthly king, was now dead. They thought it was all over. Hope was all gone. There was no future, no salvation, no kingdom. Jesus was dead. It is all over. If the story had ended with him being buried in a tomb and a stone being rolled across the door, there'd be no hope today. And there are many today who are still living in Saturday. They don't even know that, realize that Sunday has come. they're moving through the world enslaved by sin. They're moving through this world oblivious to who God is, and he exists to save them. They are moving through the world without joy, without hope, trapped in their sins and headed to hell. They live in darkness, unaware of the joy, unspeakable joy, and the full glory of theirs, that they only knew the tomb was empty. And that Jesus is alive. They will be delivered from the bondage of darkness of their sins. These three women were walking in darkness, unaware that Jesus was alive. These women were committed to prepare the body for burial, which was their custom. They were in a unified decision to go despite the obstacles that were in their way. Despite the fact that there was no one or no plan to move the stone from the tomb. They realized that they were not strong enough to do it. And they knew that the man, where were the men? Where was the disciples? Where was John and Peter and James? Where were they? Oh, yeah, that's right. They were hiding. They were scared. These women kept on walking, although the men were not there. They kept walking despite the stumbling blocks that keeps you from Jesus Christ? What immovable stone that keeps you from your kingdom assignment? What immovable stone is preventing our African American community from advancing? What immovable stone is in your life blocking you from walking in expectation? Is it the stone of unbelief? Is it the stone of your ugly past that you recall? Is it the stone names called fear and rejection and frustration and brokenness, injustice, or COVID-19? Or is it the lack of education or the lack of health care that puts a stone in your way? Regardless of what the apparent immovable stone is, you must believe that God can roll it away. Yeah. God has an appointed time to work it out. You know the song that Jesus worked it out? Is if I let him, if I just could seem to solve it, but I tried and I tried, and I kept getting deeper involved. So I turned it over to Jesus. And stopped worrying about it. Turn it over to Jesus. And he worked it out. Yeah. Somebody got to turn the stones in your life over to Jesus. Yeah. But he can work it out. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. I believe that we can visit these women as they arrived at the tomb that first Easter morning. I believe they could testify that God made a way somehow. Because they got to the burial site, and when they got there, that perceived unmovable stone was moved. God that they served, the God that we serve, the great almighty God had moved the stone away. Matthew tells us in 28th chapter, verse 2, that there was a great earthquake. And the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and rolled back the stone from the door and set upon it. God, I thank you, Lord, that the angel didn't roll it so Jesus could get out. But the angel rolled it so those desiring to see Jesus could get in. God, I thank you. The text tells us that God will meet our needs. While we're immersed in trying to figure it out, God has already taken care of it. Yeah. He removed the barrier and softened the heart. When you don't know how, God went ahead and did it. Somebody ought to give him some praise. God, I thank you. I remember Anthony Brown, he said, you made a way. Didn't know how, but you did it. You made a way. My back was against the wall. And third time in your life, your back is against the wall. He looked like it was all over, and you made a way. You were standing here only because he made a way. I know there's some witnesses in the house. You could have lost your mind, but God made a way. Didn't know how your kids were going to go to school, but God made a way. Somebody out of work right now, but I declare that God can make a way. Yeah. God, I thank you. Yeah. The ladies at the tomb were walking by faith, believing that God could do the extraordinary, the unexpected, the miraculous. Every child of God should be walking in expectation, not walking as a victim, not walking wounded, not walking discouraged, not walking upset, but walking as an expected child of God. God, I thank you. Every morning, you need to get up and say, Lord, I thank you that I expect you to show up and show out of my life. God, I expect to be blessed, going in and coming out. God, I expect not to lack anything. God, I expect to be whole and healthy. God, I thank you. I expect the families of Bethel to be blessed. I expect the families of Bethel to be whole and healthy. I expect the families of Bethel to lack not one thing. God, I thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I expect not to have COVID-19 virus. But if I get it, I know I will be healed. God, I thank you in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Witnesses in the house. Now let's take another look at the glance of these ladies as they arrived at the burial site. Matthew tells us in verse 28 and 4 that the soldiers were all unconscious, Remember them soldiers that they was a little bit concerned about who was guarding the tomb so nobody can get in? Nobody can get in to steal the body? Well, the Bible tells us that the angel, that when he came, they were in so much fear of the angels that they lay back for dead. So imagine when the women came together, they get there looking for a tomb that was sealed up with Jesus on the inside. But when they got there, God, I thank you, the tomb was open because the stone was moved away. The guard that was supposed to be guarding the tomb and keep them from coming in lay like they were dead. And they walked on inside the tomb. And when they get hot, when they got inside the tomb, they found a man dressed in white just sitting there. And there was no Jesus. Now you imagine they could be pretty much afraid. But oh God, I thank you for the angels. The angel said, do not be afraid. I thank God for the angels that listen to me day and night. When I'm afraid, there he comforts me. God, I thank you. When I'm afraid, the angel speaks to me in the midnight hour. God, I thank you for the mighty angels. The angel said, do not be afraid. The Jesus you're looking for. Yeah, that Jesus. The one that was nailed to the cross. The Jesus that was had a crown of thorns on his head. Dripping down with blood. Yeah, that Jesus. But a Roman soldier put spears in the side. And blood and water came streaming down. That Jesus. And that Father, forgive them for they know not what they do. Yeah.
Yeah! Yeah! Because he lives.
in our virtual community. Glory to God. It has never accepted Christ as your personal Savior. And you were hoping to come into an in-house worship. But even though you couldn't come into the in-house worship, you are still part of it in the virtual community. And we invite you to make the best decision of your life to accept Christ as your personal Savior. Won't you come today? You can come by tapping in to Inboxing Facebook. You can come by giving us an email via our web page, www.BethelEvanston.org. Glory to God. If you need prayer, because you want to rededicate your life back unto the Lord, certainly you can reach out. God, we thank you right now for this Resurrection Sunday. God, we thank you for the word that's gone forth. And we thank you for the music that's been sang. And oh God, we believe our heart has been touched on today, God. So God, we pray that you will draw them in to the kingdom, that none will be lost. So God, we're here. Virtual community, we're here. Come. And we receive you with loving arms. Song. If the choir would like to come up as I'm making my announcement. certainly this is starting our new week of virtual, staying connected while we're virtual, while we're apart, staying virtual connected while we're apart, excuse me. And we're making sure that every night of the week that you can connect with Bethel, amen? And we thank God for that. So Monday night, those out in virtual land, Monday night at 9 p.m., there is prayer, amen. Tuesday, 7 a.m., there is prayer, amen. Tuesday noon, we have Bible study. Wednesday, 7 p.m. is Bible study. And this week, we start a new series, 10 Miracles of Jesus, amen. And then Thursday, we're introducing a new prayer night, and that will be the prayer night regarding COVID-19. We're going to unwrap that and believe God for cleansing of the earth and for healing and all the things that has impacted the world. We'll be praying for that at 9 p.m. on Thursday. And then Friday at 7 a.m. is prayer. All of those prayer and Bible studies can be reached by way of our bridge, Conference Bridge. And that is 559-546-1200. Conference code 912-474-083-pound. On Saturday morning, 11 o'clock, we have Bible study for our youth. And you will see that on our flyer, their bridge for them. And then, of course, at 9 o'clock on Sunday morning, we have Sunday school. And then we have our 10 o'clock service by way of Conference Bridge or Facebook. And we thank you. We want to make sure that we're staying connected 7 days a week. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. On April 20th, we will have a church conference. On April 20th, that's a Monday at 7:30. We have one item of business that we need to discuss. So please mark your calendars for that day. Those that, again, be on our conference bridge. God bless you. God keep you. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this Resurrection Sunday. Hallelujah. The devil didn't have his way. Hallelujah. Because services all over the land are going forth. Throughout this holy week, last week, we all were together, whether you were together by way of phone or Facebook Live, Monday, Thursday services, Good Friday services, we still served our King. We still let the world know that Christians can still serve our King and still worship virtually. So we thank you for that. God, we thank you for this blessed day. And oh God, we pray that as families try to connect via Zoom, face-to-face, virtually, phone calls, God, that we all be blessed under your mighty hand. Hallelujah. God, we thank you for these that come to be a part of the worship experience. Bless them indeed, Father. And then, oh God, we pray that whatever's going on in individual lives out there in the virtual land, God, that you would touch them in a mighty way, God. That you would give them peace where there is anxious, God. God, you would calm their spirits where they feel fear, God. God, if they're sick by any means, God, heal their bodies. You said by your stripes we are healed. So we stand in agreement for the healing power. We stand in agreement for the blood covering power over all of us, Lord, for those sickness and disease. God, touch right now, God. God, we pray for anybody that's been abused and misused while they're sheltered in. We come against the abuser right now in the name of Jesus. God, there's somebody that's lonely because they're by themselves, God. Lord, send somebody call of us. Send a note to them, God, in the name of Jesus, Father. Oh, God, we give you glory. And God, we thank you for the opportunity to come together and worship, not just on Easter Sunday, but every day of our life. God, we thank you. We thank you for the technology that brings us together. But, oh, God, we pray that although we are not in a house of worship, that we will not forget to spend time with you quietly, God. Hallelujah, God. That our souls will be fed, God. We pray each individual person is taking time out to feed their soul, God. That they don't just take a time out because there's no in-house church. God, touch right now. And we give you glory. We give you honor. Yeah. And we give you praise, God. In Jesus' name. Amen.